Isle Royale is an island, a rather remote island, in the middle of Lake Superior, the biggest freshwater lake in the world. And on this island are a population of wolves and moose. And these wolves and moose interact with one another as predator and prey, with the wolves eating the moose, and the moose's primary cause of death being the wolves. They've been there for about 50 years together, interacting in this way, and for about the same amount of time, for 50 years, researchers from Michigan Tech University have been studying those interactions. The longer we study things on Isle Royale, the more and more we realize that our original understandings, they weren't very good. In fact, they're just plain old wrong. And the only way to get that is by continuing to watch to see that as it unfolds, it's a bit different than what you had previously thought. For many, many decades, we thought Isle Royale wolves were isolated, inbred, and showed no bad signs of that inbreeding. And you couldn't be more wrong than to find out, well, they're not so isolated and they also suffer from this inbreeding. In a normal wolf population, about 1 in 100 wolves would have some spinal type of deformity. On Isle Royale, it's about 1 in 3 wolves. So the 30 times higher rate of deformities. The other related thing is we thought for many, many decades that the wolves on Isle Royale were completely isolated. Well, we just recently this year found out that's not quite so true either. For about the last 13 years, we've been collecting the scats of wolves. From those scats, we can get DNA, and from the DNA, we can get DNA fingerprints and more or less identify one wolf from another and figure out who the brothers and sisters are and other family relationships, males and females, all that stuff we can get from these DNA. Well, what we discovered just in the past year is something that happened more than 13 years ago. In the year 1997, a wolf from Canada had come to Isle Royale. We knew about the identity of this wolf for a long time. We just never knew his heritage. We knew about him because he was really quite a spectacular wolf. He was physically larger than all the other wolves on Isle Royale. He was the leader of Middle Pack, which became one of the largest packs Isle Royale had ever seen under his leadership. His apparent superiority is one of the most strong signs you could ask for that the wolves on Isle Royale had in fact been suffering from inbreeding depression, that they weren't doing so well, because relatively speaking, he was that much better. Isle Royale has been showing us the two things that it's best at showing us. One is it shows us how easy it is for ecologists to get it wrong, how easy it is for ecologists to misunderstand how nature actually works. The other thing that Isle Royale is good at showing us is how it is that we need to think deeply about our relationship with nature in general. And how that comes into play has to do with, in the last 3 or 4 years, the wolves on Isle Royale have been doing relatively poor. They've had quite a difficult time of it. Basically, if we go back to just a couple of years ago, say early 2009, there were 4 packs on Isle Royale and about 30 wolves on the island. In just those couple of years, we're down to now about 15 adult wolves and only 1 pack. It's been 4 decades since Isle Royale has been reduced to just a single pack. So this is a very unusual time right now. At the moment, it's just the moose are a bit low in abundance. If the moose are low, there's not so much food for the wolves. Begs the question, why are the moose low? Well, one of the important reasons why the moose are low has to do with climate change. The last 10 years have been fairly warm, and a warm climate is bad for moose in a couple of different ways. They just don't do well in the summer heat. When it's hot, they don't eat as much, and when they don't eat as much, they're not getting ready for winter, and then they're not ready to make it through the whole winter. There's also a tick that bothers the moose, and that tick can have catastrophic effects on the moose. It can cause them to die in the winter time. But it turns out those ticks really do quite well when it's warm out. The last kind of critical detail about the wolves right now is that there are at most 2 adult females on the island. And if those 2 adult females, if they die before making more pups that are females, that would be the end of the wolf population. What it begs the question, what would happen if those wolves go extinct? And the question is, would it be right to reintroduce more wolves? Federally designated wildernesses, these are these places in our country where we are most proud about humans not intervening and humans not having an impact. And so the usual management for a place like this is non-intervention. And here come some of the complexities. If wolves are doing poorly because the moose are doing poorly, and if moose are doing poorly because of climate change, and if humans are the agents behind climate change, isn't that an occasion to maybe think about what's about intervening? In the last 50 years, the Lake Superior has gotten progressively warmer, and ice bridges don't form nearly as often now as they did before. And so the chances of wolves coming back on their own are quite slim for that reason. The Isle Royale is really just an example of what's kind of a big, important question for wilderness all across the United States, which is basically, there really isn't not one square inch in our country that humans haven't heavily impacted, including our wilderness areas. These human impacts are probably just an occasion for us to kind of rethink what is our relationship with nature, what is our relationship with wilderness areas in particular, and Isle Royale and this question of what to do if wolves go extinct is going to play an important role in kind of leading our thoughts to that new stage. Wide open questions, they require broad dialogue with the relevant federal agencies, but it's important for all citizens that have a stake with nature, which is all citizens. So it's a question for all of us, really.